My shift just ended. Do you wanna grab something to eat with me?
What?
You probably can't eat right now.
Do I know you?
Oh, sorry. I thought you might have recognized me. I was the paramedic the other night.
Oh, right. Yeah, I'm not really hungry right now. Do you want to get some coffee?
Sure. This is the only place I know that's open right now. Are you hungry now?
Not really.
What time were you discharged?
Around 6, I think.
So what do you do?
I'm a temp right now.
Have you always lived in Chicago?
Yeah.
Well, I've been a paramedic for about 3 years. I lived in Michigan for a while, but there wasn't a lot of people up there. Not a lot of people to save. So I moved here.
So, you get a lot of suicides?
No. This is my first time. First time being rushed to the hospital.
For this. Yeah.
Well, you were a good patient. This was fun. Maybe we could do this again sometime. Well, I didn't mean it like that. Sorry, that's a really stupid thing to say. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
No, it's not. I'm really sorry. That was pretty.
You know, you don't have to watch me. I mean, it's not like I'm gonna try to kill myself again.
Oh, come on, that's not why I brought you here. I haven't had a guy in here in a while. Plus, are you gonna give up an opportunity to sleep on the city's most comfortable couch?
I guess not.
I'll be right back. Here you go.
Thank you.
Sure. See you in the morning.
This is comfortable. Whoa, you're in a towel.
Oh, whatever. It's not like I'm naked or something. I made some coffee in the kitchen. Help yourself.
Oh, okay. Thanks. Jesus.
What?
What the hell is wrong with your coffee?
What do you mean?
How many scoops did you put in here?
I don't really make it. Maybe you can teach me sometime.
I think I probably should.
Oh shit, I forgot my wallet. I'll be right back.
Was she good?
Man, what are you talking about?
Hey, I know you fucked her. Is she good?
No.
Oh!
Scott! Jesus Christ! What the hell is the matter with you? Do I have to get a restraining order against you?
Who is this guy?
Scott, what are you doing here?
Well, I came to apologize, but you're obviously cheating on me, so...
Scott, we're not together. We will not be together again. Fuck you, leave.
Alright, fine, but... This isn't over.
So this is it.
I'm really sorry about that. He's such an asshole.
It's okay.
No, really, I should have seen this coming. He is so obsessed.
No, it's really nothing. Don't worry about it.
Well, at least let me look at your stomach for you.
Okay.
So this is a really great apartment. I guess I didn't notice last time I was in here. But I'm taking it your girlfriend decorated?
What makes you think I didn't decorate?
You're a guy.
Alright, you're right.
There's like sconces on the wall. I mean.
Yeah, she definitely decorated. I don't really like any of this stuff, but I haven't had a chance to throw it out. We actually broke up a couple weeks ago, so. And I haven't had a chance to throw it out yet because, I don't know.
You know what I think we should do? I think we should get rid of all this stuff. You know, we should like get some camera and stuff.
You think?
Yeah, I think it'll make you feel better. Yeah, let's just get rid of it all. Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Cool. Is this her?
Oh, yeah, that's her.
So what happened with you guys?
She broke up with me. She dumped me. She said that I was too sensitive, that she needed someone who would put her in her place more. Maybe be more aggressive. I don't know. I was in therapy anyway, and yeah.
Why were you in therapy, you know?
I was depressed.
Yeah, but why were you depressed?
Because I just felt like I wasn't happy. I just had nothing good going on in my life, and you know, when she left, that was pretty much it for me, and I just hit bottom, and you know, the rest.
I think you just need a new girlfriend.
Really?
Definitely. Dump it.
But in the streets, that's life, and that's average. Check it. You roll a nigga with a broke gun, you the average nigga. Yeah, you just the average nigga. You made 40 G's off a key, you the average nigga.
I'm so glad you're okay, dude. Cameron.
Sean. What are you doing?
Oh, we're gonna get through this, buddy. Everything's gonna be okay.
Hello.
Cameron, what's up?
Yeah, I will.
Sorry. Well, let me know if you need anything, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Hey, Cameron.
Oh, yes. Work?
Sure.
You know, sir, if it's all the same, I'd really just rather not talk about this.
Sit down, Cameron. You know, I don't know if maybe this is all about Jenna, but I need you to know we've got your back. You understand? So, what was going on in your head?
I don't know.
Okay, well, I need you to take a couple days off. Take off enough time to really clear your head. Well, you understand. You got my number.
Thank you, sir.
It's the drum part on this that really gets me. It's in this weird time signature. I can't even really, like, dig it out. I think it's, like, 5-7, which is kind of...
Really? Is that a thing?
Yeah, I think that's what it is.
The guitar stays right in step with it, but it's also playing, like, this weird time. I don't really know how the math works
it's,
on that.
It's 3-4.
Really?
Yeah.
And the other is in 5-6?
5-7.
5-7.
Yeah. It's like some...
How does that work if you have an even and an odd?
Well,
it's complicated, but it has something to do with intervals. Like, so if you have like, you know, like
comes back around again and meets up.
Right.
Like
yeah.
Around. Like row, row, row your boat.
Yeah, kind of like that.
I don't think that's what's happening here.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'd agree with you, but you're wrong.
Hey, dude.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Cam. I just wanted to say, you know, with everything.
I don't want to talk about it right now.
Dude, where are the knives?
Oh, I got it in my bag.
You just want to play it safe.
If you need your scissors, let me know.
Guys, be somewhere else tonight for a few hours, okay?
I got a date, so, you know, just make yourself scarce.
I'm gonna go see if there's something on.
I don't need you guys here babysitting me, okay?
Melting mountains as the temperature did rise, and the tide rose too and swallowed up our island country. We rode our snowy beastly friends to the provinces of Canada. We asked the mooses why they're moving, and they said we tried to warn ya. To the greater states that gripe in North America about the heat that seems to worsen every year.
Sucks, first of all. I don't know what you did to that shit, but it was bad. So I'm gonna show you how to make it the right way, okay? I set this up before we got home, and this is it. So you get your premium roast.
Value red.
Basically, what you do to make good cappuccino is you take this little guy. If you want 2 cups, fill it to the 2-cup mark with the roast. If you want 4 cups, you fill it to the 4-cup mark. Okay? So basically, I'm going to do this. Okay? We're going to have great, great cappuccino right now. $2 cappuccino. Do we want 4 cups?
No.
I think we should put 4 cups in.
No.
Why not?
There are only 2 of us.
But what if we get thirsty? So you take, put it in. Okay? Let's. And with cappuccino, you want to pack it in kind of tight in there. So, okay? Okay, so then you take the thing, you put it in here like this, okay? And then what we're going to do is we're going to screw the top off, okay? I'm going to fill this up with water. You take the water and you pour it in here. Then you twist this knob, okay? You take the knob, turn it to where it says brew. And now you wait. Here it comes.
Wait for it. Cheers.
Cheers.
Wow, this is really good.
There you go.
Yeah, maybe you can, you know, come over and make me cappuccino every day.
I would love to. You want to watch a movie?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. I've got a great one. You're going to love it.
Yeah? Okay.
Okay. Jenna,
Cameron.
You're here.
I heard you tried to kill yourself?
Yeah, but you know what? I'm over it now.
Cameron, I'm so sorry. I had no idea that you felt so strongly about our relationship.
Yeah, well, like I said, I'm fine now, so, you know.
Who's this?
This is Sarah.
Hi.
Are you sleeping with her?
Yeah. You and I broke up, remember?
Cameron, come over here so I can talk to you for a second.
No, Jenna, I won't.
Cameron, don't be difficult, okay? Just come over here. I came over here to say I'm sorry, to make it better. Just come on over here. Cameron, I am so sorry. Okay, I wish I could just take it all back.
Yeah, right.
What did you say, bitch?
Excuse me?
Yeah, you heard me right. Who do you think you are? Who the hell do you think you are? You're in my apartment on my couch with iPod Urban Outfitters.
You've been watching
you,
here. What are you doing?
I doubt you want.
I live here
a lot more than you do.
Look. Jenna, I have some of your shit. It's over there. Why don't you come back later and get it, though? Because this is clearly not a good time.
This is ridiculous.
No, I'm going to put myself back on the wall because it looks much better than what you think.
He tried to kill himself because of you. What the fuck? I saved him.
Yeah, Joe, the plumber, found me in the bathtub, and she was the paramedic that came and rescued me.
Well, go ahead.
Jenna, please don't be upset.
So I made you want to kill yourself? I was such a horrible person.
No, you're not, okay? I was just in a bad place. I was on those meds, and I was really unhappy, and then you left, and that was the end, you know?
Okay. You redecorated.
What? Yeah, I did.
I thought you liked what I did.
Well, I think this looks more... It's better for me. It's more Cameron.
Okay. Are you, like, mad at me?
No, Jenna, I'm not mad at you. You know, I would actually really like it if we could be friends. Do you think that's possible?
Yeah. Yeah, I think we can be friends.
Okay.
So you just like had a one night stand with that girl, right? I mean, you're not gonna really like stay with her, are you? She's no good for you. Look, I have a friend that I can set you up with. She's really pretty.
Oh my god.
She's really smart.
Are you serious?
She'd be perfect for you to really like her.
You know what? Fuck this. I take it all back. You are a horrible person, and I want nothing more to do with you, okay? I'm done. We're done. It's over.
Cameron!
No, it's over. It's over. Sarah? Fuck.
Hi.
Hi.
Are you mad at me?
No, I'm not mad. Why would I be mad? Because my boyfriend went running after his ex-girlfriend? No, not mad. No.
Look, Sarah, it's complicated. Like, I work for her father, and... Wait, did you say I'm your boyfriend?
I thought that's what was going on. We're dating, aren't we?
Well, yeah, I just didn't know you thought of me that way.
Well, I do.
I feel the same way. Can I come in?
Fine, but I'm still mad.
Okay.
Seriously, like, she starts crying and so you just run to her? What the fuck?
Yeah, I know, and I'm sorry. But what do you want me to do? I mean... You know what? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna cut her out of my life. Completely. Just pretend like she never even happened. I won't try to make her happy. I won't try to fix things and make her feel better. I'll just forget about her. Is that okay?
Do you promise?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. Hi, Jenna.
Hi, it's so nice to see you again.
Yeah, since I'm such a nice person, I thought I would give you fair warning. I'm gonna get him back.
How do you plan on doing that?
I know what he likes and what he doesn't like, and I know how to make him happy, and he doesn't belong to you, so fair warning.
You know what? Since I'm such a nice person, and you did warn me, I guess I won't come over there right now and kick your prissy little ass.
Funny, I was on my way over here, and I was just thinking about that time we were in the kitchen.
Sean, do you have the dental floss?
Yeah.
Dude, what was I gonna do with dental floss? Okay, Jenna, I'm gonna stop you right there because, first of all, I'm not gonna fuck you because I have a new girlfriend now. And she's awesome, unlike you.
I
Shh, Jenna, I'm talking. Also, nice try coming over here trying to seduce me. I know you're doing it just to piss Sarah off. And guess what? It's not working.
You're an asshole.
Yeah, I am an asshole. And I don't want you coming around here starting shit, okay? The problem in our relationship wasn't me, it was you.
No, our relationship was fine. I just happened to have needs, Cameron.
No, Jenna. Me trying to please you all the time, that is not what a relationship should be. Okay, that is not love. And I should know, because I know what love is now, because I'm in love. Bye, Jenna.
Fuck you, Cameron.
Hi, Jenna.
Fuck off.
Bye, Jenna.
Go to hell!
Hey.
Hey. She's mad.
Yeah, I told her she's cut off. What?
I'm just happy.
So, are you okay now?
Yeah, fine. What do you mean?
I don't know, like, you're not gonna try to kill yourself again or something, are you?
No. No, I'm not, actually. I think I'm... Yeah, I'm fine. I'm happy now. You know, I think I have something to look forward to, you know, every day.
You know, actually, there's something I really want to show you. Come back to my place. There's something I've been wanting to talk to you about.
Okay.
I wanted to show you this box because I, when I was younger, I would use these, and you know, when it got too overwhelming, and I just felt like I couldn't control anything, things kind of felt too big. And, but then I guess just one day, I woke up, I realized I didn't want to live that way anymore, and it wasn't my fault, so, and I just really want you to know it's not your fault, too.
Yeah, that's right. I cut him on purpose.
Why?
because I didn't like myself. And Scott, I'm really not liking you right now. So unless you want to look like this, I suggest you leave me and Sarah alone. You got it?
I got it. Just let me up.
Fuck. Fuck, man.
Dang, dude. Now, Jesus, look at you. You're a mess.
I know, man. I know. Just fucking back off, alright?
Yeah. I'll back off, but you gotta do something for me. You need to go talk to somebody. You need some help. I mean, you got a problem. Obviously, I have a problem. I've been drinking outside your apartment. That's a problem. But, you know, I mean, you're a good guy. And, you know, as far as I'm concerned, we're not going to have any problems from now on.
That's good.
Because you want to know why? You want to know why? Because it's not even about you. It's about her and all of them. They do this to us. We're not like this. It's about them. They fuck with us. So you gotta have a good night. This is about fucking women. And fucking...
Bye, Scott.
Hey. Did Scott do that?
Yeah, but it's okay. Don't worry about it.
No, I'm calling the cops.
No,
this is getting out of hand.
Don't call. It's fine. We have an agreement. We have an understanding. So don't worry about it, okay? Listen.
No, this is bullshit.
It's okay. Look, we talked. We have an agreement. We talked about it. We worked it out. Everything's fine now, okay? Come here. Everything's gonna be all right.
Baby, and my feet are tied. In your dreams, the desert was never so wide. But it brings me out, and I feel dry. Like a sunbathed garment that tears mending somehow. It feels beautiful, like your mother's eyes. Arizona, where the sky and earth meet. And if you can't take the heat, you should know the sun fills the sky. It's the reason people go to Arizona to die. But it rings me out, and I feel dry. Like a sunbathed garment that tears mending somehow. Your mother's eyes, it feels beautiful. The birds above us, the buzzards circling over our heads. The sandstorms come to claim our bodies.